for an auditor profession like me, this experience gives sense to our life. And it's been an honor for me to be here this last 7 weeks working for you. I am the one who must thank you for the opportunity. And I'll talk very briefly what I was able to do. Since we didn't have access to the information Zoe just mentioned, I dedicated all my time to study the agreements, these complicated agreements, as today Professor Elias confirmed, because it's a way to make things not understandable, to make them very complicated, and even try to show they are serious, because they are so complicated. Yeah, this is a tricky thing. Well, but we studied, and we could reach the mechanisms. What we call mechanisms is how the mechanisms explain how the agreements served to private interests. How the money borrowed never served Greece. How it went straight either to bondholders or to recapitalization of banks, private banks. You have access to the report. You see in chapter 4 explained some steps we could figure out on those agreements. Of course, they need confirmation. They need confirmation, for example, from the Hellenic Fund created under the memorandum determination. I'm talking about the HFSF, the Hellenic Stability Fund in Greece. This fund received 48.2 billion euros in financial instruments from the European Financial Stability Fund, the EFSF, the private company located in Luxembourg, created in 2010 as a company, as a private company. Why it was organized like a private company? Professor Elias explained this today also. He said, this is to be away from obeying the international law. And total absurds have been done to just to provide funds for private banks. So, what happened in 2010? The banks, as Eric mentioned, the banks had a problem. The banks were in crisis. And they were not in crisis because they financed many countries or people. No, they were in crisis because they had issued such an amount of toxic instruments. They balance their balances and their off-balances items were out of administration, and they need a solution. In May 2010, this EFSF, this company, was created in Luxembourg to become a vehicle, a special vehicle, to transfer these toxic assets to the public banks. And if we look at the balance sheet of Bank of Greece, we'll see that the off-balance items are much greater than the assets. They did it. They did the transfer they wanted. Besides, what else was done in May 2010? The ECB launched a program totally illegal, the SMP, illegal under Article 123 of EU Treaty. This program allowed ECB buy any kind of bonds, public and private bonds, to help the banks. Besides, it would be illegal, the simple transfer of assets without sell-buying operations. Eurostat changed the rules. And besides, IMF gave 200 billion euros to EFSF. We have here at least four illegal things at the time. The creation of the private company, the S&P program, the change of rules by Eurostat, and the help from IMF to EFSF. Four, this would be a scandal. So many illegal things to help banks. Then comes Greece as a scenery, and everything was done to save Greece. That's why we have such illegal agreements, such unusable mechanisms for Greece, because we are under a fraud. We are under a big fraud that utilized Greece and made these agreements. So we must follow all this work. We must confirm all this, because the truth must prevail. And I'm very proud to be able to be part of this committee. Thank you very much for the opportunity. And we hope this work will go on so that we can bring everything into light. Thank you.